study who had a study about the credit conditions, and I hope you can understand that today we are going to learn about the central bank and its functions. So what is central bank basically? As we know, this any country has its own central bank. Like in America, their central bank name is Federal Bank. In England, that is Federal Bank of England, Bank of England. And in India, that is what is RBI, is the Bank of India. It was established in 1st April 1935. RBI, Federal Bank of India, was established in India. Okay. So today we will learn about what the function of central bank, how it operates basically. So central bank is an apex body that controls, operates, regulates, and directs the entire banking system. That means we have the commercial bank. Yesterday already about the commercial bank. So what central bank does? An apex body, which is supreme at top level, and that controls to all the banking systems and operates all the operations they do and regulates all the rules and regulations they carry forward, and that is the banking system, right? So the central bank. So in India we have central bank, that is called RBI, Reserve Bank of India. Now we are going to that function of central bank, what it does is today. The first and important function of central bank is currency authority. That means bank, if they issue the notes, that is called bank issue. So what it does basically, central bank has the sole authority for issue of currency in the country. So any country notes, as you know, only the central bank, the RBI in India, they have the sole authority for issue of currency in the country. So all the paper currency issued by the RBI in India, except 1 rupee notes and coins. 1 rupee note and coins issued by the finance ministry. So here we can understand central bank is obliged to how, like you know that if they are having deficit budgets, they can issue their notes. So it is not like that. So what if they can do? Central bank is obliged to pay the currency with the assets equal value. What about even the paper notes and currency they want to issue? So what they will do, that central bank is obliged to pay the currency with the assets of equal value. The same how much amount they want to issue that notes. So they will keep there as a reserve. So how in the form of actual deals, like gold coins they will keep, and gold bullions and foreign currency and local currency, they will keep the same, they will keep that equal value of assets. Then they can issue their paper notes. Then people they have confidence in that paper notes. So what is the advantage of that one? So if we have like different bodies in country, like 2-3 every state, they have their own, like they can issue their notes. What problem they can have? That we will not have uniformity. So any states will go, they will say that this money, this currency, this is not in a circular. So here the central bank, they have banking system they have control over in the country. So the first advantage is it leads to the uniformity in the note circulations. So in our country, only the central bank they issue the notes, so it leads to uniformity. There is uniformity here in note circulations. In any states, we can that money that can be circulated here easily. The second advantage is easy to supervision and control. The RBI, the monetary policy and fiscal policy remain such a way, so they quite easily they can control over the credit conditions, and public has faith in the currency system as well. So these are the benefits of RBI, the first currency authority, bank of they issue their notes. So these are the functions of the central bank. The second function of central bank is banker to the governments. Banker to the government means RBI acts as a banker. RBI is the Bank of India, acts as a banker for whom? Like agent. They act like a banker, agent, and financial advisor to the central government. Like they are used like advisors, these are the bank to the governments. RBI is the bank to the governments, like all the current accounts they have in the of the governments, all the payments and receipts they keep in their governments, and always they work like advisors and agents, financial advisors and agents to the central governments. So that's why we say the banker to the governments. RBI is a Reserve Bank of India, a central bank of any country, that is called the banker to the governments. And the third function is bankers. So what they do brothers, basically, so they do these three functions they do, then the bank span, the scheduling of cash figures. So all the like, we know that in the central banks, what they does, keeps certain proportion of their deposit as CRR, like all the commercial banks, they keep some amounts as per the directory and direction of central banks, they keep cash reserve ratio in the central banks. So if anything happens, they are about the custodian of cash reserves. If anything happens, they are the custodians. They will keep their the central bank, they will keep the money. If anything happens of commercial bank, they will take the custodian. They are the guardian of that bank. The second option is lender of last resort. Lender of last resort means what that does, as we know that the commercial bank, they deposit in the central bank as a CRR, the some amount they keep there. So lender of last resort means central banks need to give the financial requirements. If something happened, they are not able to operate properly. So lender of last resort, because they have the money as a CRR in the central bank, so they can go, they can ask for the loans, and they can advance their loans, and they can borrow loans from the central banks, and they can run their business. The third function is, third function of a banker's bank is clearing house. They work like a clearing house. They like all the commercial banks, they have their accounts and they keep their CRR, like cash reserve ratio in the central banks. So some amount they have here, they have some problem in bank to bank, like SBI have problem with the Punjab National Bank, some amount is pending, they are not, they have disputed that one. So these disputes, they can be solved by the central bank because this is the apex body. So it works like a agent, as a clearing house. They have their bond, they can pay to other parties. And here is the last function is control of money supply and credit. Like they, what it is, the control of money supply. Money supply, we know that if they have the control system, if you know the money supply will be more, then the problem is happens. So these are the like monetary policy they follow that one, like bank that we have expected here. Okay, like CRR, like cash reserve ratio, if they will increase the cash reserve ratio, what will happen? It will affect our economy as well. The commercial banks, they will deposit more money, they will have less money, their money supply will be less. So we will learn in the next topics. Here, like control of money supply, what it does, there is one technique that is called repo rate, repurchase rate. The banking system, what happens, the rate at which the central banks of the country lends money to commercial banks for short period of time. Repo rate means the rate at which central bank of the country lends money. This to money that is a commercial bank for short period of time. For 6 months, for 1 year, if they lends money to commercial bank, that is called the repo rate. If repo rate will be increased, repo rate jyada ho jayega, commercial bank, they will borrow less amount, less money. Otherwise, they will lend to money to customers, that will be increased. So what will happen, the economy, like people will go for the less, number of people will not go for the loans. So that is also like we use as a technique to control over the credit policy and monetary policy by the government. So central bank always, they are like with the repo rate increasing and decreasing as per the situations of the economy. The second is bank rate. Bank rate is the rate at which the central bank lends money to commercial bank for long period of time. Only the difference is the repo rate and the bank rate is like the same, only the this is the for the short period of time. Repo rate, they give money to commercial banks for short period of time. A bank rate at which the central bank lends money to commercial bank for long period of time, for 1 year or 2 years, 5 years, 10 years, that is for long period of time, that is the bank rate. If bank rate will increase, then the the commercial bank, they will go for the less model for borrow money, and their lending rate will be high, so that like credit issue will be equal, and that can money supply they can control over there. The third is reverse repo rate. Reverse repo rate is the opposite of repo rate. When commercial bank have surplus funds, commercial bank has surplus fund, what they will do, they can deposit the same amount in the central banks and they will earn their interest. So that is the reverse repo rate. Repo rate means when the we are studying here, when the central banks lends money to the commercial bank. The reverse repo, when commercial bank have money, surplus money, they will pass this money to central banks and they will earn their any interest. So that is the reverse repo rate. So today class we learned about function of central bank and central bank. In the next class, we will learn some more techniques about the open market and other things. So, in next class, we will do that one. Okay, have a nice day.